Hey, what's up? Coach Myers here with another edition of Muscle Meals. Welcome to my kitchen. I'm going to bring you today a nice, simple, easy turkey burger recipe that you can do inside. You don't need to use a grill. I know it's that time of year where, you know, you can't really cook outside as often. So I'm going to teach you one that you can make in a pan, low fat, low carb. Let's go. Let's see what we got here. All right, you're going to start out. You need a pound of turkey. I went with the 93 lean. 7% fat. You can go for the 99 lean. It's going to be a good bit drier though. You know, we're not really worried about, you know, too much fat. We just don't want like 70-30 or something like that. Now, the key for these turkey burgers are you got to season them up a little bit. We got to make a nice seasoning mix to give them a little bit better texture because they're not very juicy. So we're going to take an egg, some salt and pepper, some soy sauce, some garlic, some scallions or green onions, and some type of bell pepper. Now, if you don't want to use green onions, you can use a regular onion. I would use probably, for 1 pound of beef, no more than like a fourth of a small onion. But the key is, you're gonna want to dice that onion up very fine. Same thing with this pepper, and you'll see when I dice it up. Very small pieces. You don't want to cook these turkey burgers with very large chunks of vegetables in there because they won't cook all the way through. It'll be a little bit too crunchy. So let's get this prepped, mix it up, throw it in the pan, and go. I'm hungry. We'll just get a little bit of soy sauce in there. It's probably a tablespoon or so. Now the parsley, I usually measure it out in my palm. There you go, that looks like about a tablespoon. Throw that in. Cracked pepper. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're making 4 burgers, so you figure that's one crack for each burger. Get a red pepper in there. Onions. Now we need some garlic. Now if you don't have whole garlic, you can use powdered or granulated garlic. I like to use fresh garlic myself, and for something like this I'll use 2 cloves, and I'll either press it or just chop it up real fine. Now with garlic you always want to cut off the ends, and then if you still got some shell on it, well, that one came off pretty good. Use the side of your knife to get it to loosen up, and we won't press this, but we're gonna slice it very thin. Remember in the movie Goodfellas, they had when they were locked up in the joint and they were cooking spaghetti, they took a razor blade and they were cutting it very thin. One of my favorite scenes in Goodfellas. Don't put too many onions in the sauce. He always puts too many onions. How many onions you put in the sauce?
Put too many onions in the sauce. I didn't put too much onions in
it. For all you mafia movie heads out there, that was a great movie. Probably my favorite movie of all time. Oh yeah, these babies are gonna be nice and garlicky. So now we got our egg, our soy sauce, our seasoning, our green onion, our bell pepper. We're gonna mix that up really good, and then that's what we're gonna use to season that turkey with, dress it up a little bit. Now if you're not on a low carbohydrate diet, you may want to even add like some breadcrumbs or, you know, some Italian breadcrumbs that'll really even soften the burgers up a little bit more. Give it more almost like a meatloaf texture, but you know, generally stay away from that. I'm always eating low carb. Get this on medium heat, let it heat up. Throw some olive oil in there. Now, here is a very key part, and also the gross part about turkey burgers. We gotta hand mix this, we gotta fold it together, make sure this mixture gets all the way through, not just on the outside. Now, to me, I don't know, there's just, I don't mind ground beef, ground turkey, ground chicken, there's just some kind of gross about touching it. But it's a necessary evil. If we wanna make good turkey burgers, we gotta really get in there and get our hands dirty. So you kinda mix it around, fold it up, push it through. Again, because we got a lot of chunky stuff in here, and if you don't mix it properly, it's just gonna end up on the outside of the burger. We want, you know, especially the garlic and the onion, you know, the stuff that's really gonna add flavor to the burgers. We really want that to, you know, get pushed all the way through the meat. Okay, so for that pound of burger, the turkey burger, I'm gonna break this up in about 4 equal parts. It's gonna be kind of like a mushy meatball like that. Or patty it out. You can make them any shape you want, but I always keep it kind of a traditional burger shape. You wanna try to get uniform thickness. You want all these to be about the, even if they're not the same size, what is key is that they're the same thickness, because then they're gonna have the same cooking time. Oh yeah, that's the good stuff right there. See, what did I tell you? It's kind of slimy. It's gonna taste good though, so that's the important thing. And very healthy, you know, kind of a low calorie alternative to a regular burger. So this time of year, you guys getting ready for maybe a winter vacation or spring break right around the corner. Yeah, that's a good alternative to beef. Although, I do like beef way better. But these are awesome too, nice little change up. All right, once I get this fourth one in there, we're gonna let them cook on medium heat and then olive oil for about 5 minutes. At the 5 minute mark, I'm gonna go ahead and flip them. And once I flip them, if it seems like the pan's a little dry, I'll add a little bit of oil, but it should be all right. I'll go ahead and cover them too and cook them covered for the last 5 minutes. That way we make sure they cook all the way through. Now with ground beef, or with lamb or with bison, it can still be pink in the middle, but with this turkey, you wanna make sure it's fully cooked. You don't wanna eat it, you know, medium or medium rare. So we will cover it for the last 5 minutes. So back in the day, like in my bodybuilding days, now this would have been, I don't know, early 2000s, I would have been like early 20s. I can remember following the bodybuilding diet. You know, it was very, very low calorie, low carb, even low fat. So, you know, I didn't really feel good on it. And I remember one of the meals I would make very regularly was turkey burgers. But at the time, you know, I wasn't as good at cooking. So I would literally take the pound of turkey out, patty it up, add some maybe garlic, salt, and pepper. And then I would cook them until they were like hockey pucks on the George Foreman grill. And I can remember like day after day eating these dry, you know, lifeless turkey burgers with like a can of green beans. You know, so for any of you, you know, bodybuilders or aspiring bodybuilders out there, you don't have to be miserable with the way that you have to eat to get lean. You know, you can make these burgers, these turkey burgers taste good and then still be, you know, very low calorie. You just gotta season them up right, you know. So I wish I would have known how to cook these then, because maybe I wouldn't have been so miserable. You know, and plus the George Foreman really dries them out. I'm a big fan of the cast iron skillet, so there you go. All right, it's been about 5 minutes. So we're gonna take a look at these burgers, see if they're ready to flip. Now, turkey, when you pan fry it, it's gonna get brown and a little bit like burnt looking, but you don't want it to look black. That means you don't have enough oil in your pan. So let's kind of see how these babies are looking here. Oh, perfect, look at that. Nice crust on it, starting to harden up. Let's see, let's flip this one first. Same thing. And you gotta be kind of careful flipping them, because the turkey doesn't really stay together like beef does until it's fully cooked. Then it, you know, solidifies a lot better. There we go. So those are looking great. And if you notice, nice and brown, but not burnt. Cooking it on medium, you don't wanna cook it too hot. We're gonna go ahead and cover it for the last 5 minutes, and they should be cooked through and ready to eat. All right, I'm gonna tell you guys a secret story about Corey G Fitness. They're probably, no one outside of maybe our roommates back in 1999 when we lived on 180 East 12th Avenue on campus at Ohio State. Those might be the only people that know this story. So this is a good one. Now, Corey G, this was his first time living away from home, and we probably had lived in the apartment maybe a week or two. And I think I went and bought groceries. And, you know, we're college students. So we're, like, surviving on, you know, macaroni and cheese and ramen noodles and stuff. Well, I had bought, you know, some ramen. No, it wasn't ramen noodles. Was it? Rice-a-roni. So remember the old rice-a-roni packs, right? It was like a, you know, chicken and broccoli rice-a-roni pack. And we were, like, lifting down in our little crawl space. And I think, like, I told him, I said, like, you know, I think we would take turns cooking at that time. And I said, hey, why don't you go make one of those rice-a-roni packs, go put that on, so as soon as we're done lifting, we can eat it. So he goes, puts it on, he's cooking it or whatever. We get done with the workout, come up, doing something. We go to sit down, and he's like putting it into the bowls, and it's like soup. Now, you know those rice-a-roni packs, it's supposed to kind of thicken up after it sits a little bit. But this is like, you could have poured it out. I'm like, you use way too much water. I said, gee. I said, how much water did you use? He said, I just followed the recipe on the back. I said, no way. I said, there's no way you followed the recipe. It's way too much water. This is like a gallon of water. He said, D, I followed the recipe. He started getting a little bit defensive about it. I said, okay, show me what you did. He said, well, look, it says 2 cups. I said, all right, where's the measuring cup? He's like, measuring cup? So he didn't use a measuring cup. He used the cup that we had left over from Taco Bell that was like a jumbo size drink. I don't know what those are, 30 ounces or something. He used 2 full cups of that instead of 2 8-ounce measuring cups. We had a good laugh about it. I think I busted his balls for a good year or two after that one. So anyway, I'm sure by now Corey's learned how to use a measuring cup. That's a little back in the day Corey G trivia for you. All right, 5 minutes with them uncovered, 5 minutes with the turkey burgers covered. We are gonna cut one of them open, see if they're close to being done here. We'll cut it. I always try to pick the thickest one. That one looks just slightly thicker. And it looks like it's still a little bit soft in the middle. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go ahead and recover them. I'm gonna let them cook for 1 more minute like that. And then I'm gonna turn the heat off and let them sit covered for another 2 minutes. So they'll still continue to cook. We just don't wanna leave them on that heat for too long because they're gonna end up burning on the bottom. So 1 more minute on the heat, turn the heat off, 2 more minutes. Now, if you cut it open and it looks nice and solid, then you're done. But you really gotta make sure the turkey burgers are cooked all the way through. All right, so now after sitting covered for another 2 minutes, that's perfect. You see the texture, it's done all the way through, you know, but still kind of spongy, not too dry. These babies are ready to eat. Now you can pair this with a salad, any type of vegetable, you can eat it, you know, with a bun. I'm just gonna throw a little sriracha on there, my signature M, and a pickle slice and get to town. So thanks for watching. Let me know how these turkey burgers go for you. Make sure to go to maxevermuscle.com for all your supplement needs, all your training needs. Let us teach you how to cook, how to get your mind right, how to live. Let's go. So after you fry something in a pan, if it is like an absolute mess and there's stuff that's stuck to it, the longer you let it sit, the harder it's gonna be clean. The easiest way is just throw a couple ounces of water in there, turn it up on high, let it boil, and then just kind of scrape along, and then that stuff's gonna come right off, and then you can wash it, you know, clean it as you normally would once you get that stuff that's really stuck off of there. That is a knowledge bomb right there. We'll be right back.